Hey everyone, how's it going?
Hey guys!
Cooking Show 101.
101.
And I'm excited about this because we've had this once before.
We have. Can I first address the pink bandage on my arm?
Oh yeah. It wasn't a cooking injury.
No, it wasn't, thank goodness. Eddie didn't stab me with a knife.
No.
Not this time. I got my blood drawn today.
Yeah,
yay.
So what a pretty pink
Isn't
bandage.
Isn't that pretty?
Yeah, there you go. So anyway, we had this, was it last week?
It was a little over a week ago.
Just about over a week ago at Alex's sister's house. Cameron, this inspired us.
It was delicious. So good. It was chicken pesto, right?
Yep.
Chicken pesto sandwich is what we had there. And so we jumped on. I found a pesto recipe from somebody I follow on Instagram that we're going to try out with our chicken. How did we make this chicken?
Well, the thing is, we just got literally chicken breasts and boiled up a pot of water. Did you actually put the chicken in first? Just remind me.
So you cubed up the chicken,
put it in the water,
yep.
Brought it to the boil, and then simmered it for 10 minutes on a medium heat.
Yeah.
And the chicken's cooked. And then Alex, basically, you can probably see it there, shredded the chicken up nicely. And I tried a little bit of it. It's actually really tasty.
A ton of chicken.
I've never boiled chicken before. I've roasted it, I've grilled it,
I've never burnt it
plenty of times, right? But I've never boiled it, and I'm really shocked, and it was really fast.
Yeah, but check it out. I mean, that is a ton of chicken. I mean,
how many different breasts were there? Was it? Was it six?
There's actually probably six in there.
Six breasts.
We went to Costco and got the big packages, so we froze them and then stuck them in the boiling. And this will feed a family of 25, probably.
Well, depends how big their appetites are, right?
Yes. So
that's
cool. How we made the chicken.
So the chicken's done and it's boiled and it's shredded, ready to have the pesto mix put in.
Yeah.
And you know the thing about you can't do this obviously unless we have smell-o-vision, but I just love the smell of this is basil, isn't it?
Yeah, basil.
Basil, it's basil. I love the smell of this, and I love the whole smell of pesto. It's just so Italian restaurant, and I'm excited about this.
So let's make it. Not a ton of ingredients. We have our basil. So 2 cups of basil.
Yeah.
We have a half cup of extra virgin olive oil.
Can you show to this camera?
Yep, go for it.
So this is virgin olive oil. You can see that.
Extra virgin olive oil, absolutely.
Oh, is that half a cup?
A half a cup.
Okay.
A third a cup of walnuts.
Okay. You can see that.
Ooh, I think it's just a delivery. We have a third a cup of Parmesan cheese.
Okay.
We have 3 teaspoons of minced garlic.
There you go.
And we have salt and pepper to taste.
Salt and pepper.
We are doing it in our Ninja. You could also do it in a food processor or a blender, but we're gonna try our Ninja out. So basically what you do is you just throw all this in.
Do it.
Wanna do it?
Do it.
You're gonna help me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Basil, the basil's going in.
Basil.
Okay. That's going to be so good.
Yeah.
There's the walnuts.
Let's
turn this one. Okay. Clean as you go. Okay. Garlic's in. Okay, it smells amazing already.
Oh my gosh.
And that's without the basil being chopped up.
And then salt and pepper to taste.
You like pepper. How much salt? Give me a B, because I always put too much salt in and Alex gets mad. Is that enough?
Couple more.
Oh, you're going for it. She's going for it.
We're gonna cap that baby off and we're just gonna pulse him.
Okay.
I don't know how loud it's gonna be.
Just talk amongst yourselves while we pulse it. That's what I call green.
Check it out. Look at that.
Right.
Oh, that's, there it is.
Let's smell this. Still gonna stab myself in the eye. Oh my gosh, that's just so good.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna show how to make one portion, all right? With our portion control. So basically what you want me to do, you want me to put in one of these of chicken?
Yep, one red.
So I have got clean hands, in case you're wondering. Okay, so. Okay, so we got a red. Is that enough red? That's pretty much what you're looking for. I always make sure, because I always go over the top, and I make sure to keep it to the portions right. So we got one red of chicken, and you want some yogurt?
One red of Greek yogurt.
yogurt. Greek yogurt going in. I'm trying to fill my red container up. That looks pretty good. Okay.
Awesome.
Okay.
And then we're just gonna test this out. Right now I'm gonna start with 1 teaspoon. Little bit goes a long way.
That actually looks quite a lot, so I think it's gonna be good. You wanna do the mixing now?
You're
more delicate than I am. What's that?
I could probably put another thing in here.
You think? It's quite a lot of yogurt.
Yeah.
You wanna put some more pesto in?
Let's put more chicken.
More chicken?
Yeah. Maybe another red.
A whole red. You're going off recipe. Okay. Okay. That looks good. So you put in 2 chicken to 1 yogurt.
Yes.
Okay, we're learning as we go here. This is like, this is cooking 101. Learn as you go.
Okay.
You're gonna do that taste.
I'll let you taste it.
I'm gonna get a little fork and taste this.
Ooh, I taste that pesto.
Oh my gosh.
That's good. Wait your mouth up.
The chicken's soft from the boiling. Mm. The yogurt's got a good tang, and then the pesto.
Yep. That's great, you guys. So easy to make, makes a ton. Again, these are just the portions we're going with. Maybe you don't want it as wet, don't add as much Greek yogurt. Maybe you want it wetter, add more Greek yogurt.
But the good
thing is, it's all to your taste.
This is, the flavors are amazing. Mm-hmm. This is super healthy, because
yep.
The chicken is, let's say it's been boiled, there was no skins on the chicken.
Yep.
We're actually gonna wrap, put this in a wrap.
So this is the wrap that we put it in, Ezekiel wrap. So we're probably gonna keep this wrap up in the oven a little bit, or on top of the stove. Put this guy on top of it, and it's just going to be delicious and healthy.
I'm going to keep eating it.
Yeah. So if you guys have any questions, let us know. We will put the ingredients and the directions and the recipe in the post. But enjoy. Bon appetit.
So good. See you, everyone.
Bye, guys.